Yes. So when we think of our country, what is the one thing that comes to our minds? Diversity. India is a diverse land, various cultures, various cuisines, various, you can say, folks, all are living in a single country. But since though there is diversity, but there is unity among the people. People are living with complete unity. All are following and abiding the rules of constitution. Everyone has freedom to speech. Everyone has freedom to express, to celebrate. And but it is again a very interesting to read about our country, because India is not only a country which is an attraction for the people of India also. It is, of course, an attraction for the foreigners also, because of the various, you can say, because of its location that you have studied in your social science, because of the various kind of, you can say, minerals, okay, and the living style of people, the culture of India. Britishers were also attracted towards India, okay, and they wanted to have it a part of their own kingdom. But ultimately, that was just the bloodshed of our freedom fighters that did not allow them to invade it. And finally, it is, of course, a source of attraction. It has a rich source of knowledge also. Okay, the great concept of zero was given by Indians. Many, you can say, scientific facts, they have their origin back to India. Though many latest inventions, they are being made in this field, but still they date back to India. And there are many things that we people also know about our country. Okay, so here we are going to study about it. First of all, this first excerpt is from Baker from Goa. Next, second part of the activity is there. What parts of India have you lived in or visited? Can you name some popular tourist destinations? So let us have a look over it. Which parts you have gone or you have visited in India? Have you ever got a chance? Which one? Himachal, right? Kolkata. So what you have seen in Kolkata means speciality of Kolkata. Simarpreet, stand up from there and go to that side. Yes. Metro, okay. Stadiums, industries much developed there. Education literacy rate is higher. Okay. And thinking of people is also of different type. Next. Which one? Okay. Any other place that you have visited? Sit down, please. Thank you. So whatever, the thing is that when you visit the different states, there are varieties of cultures. You come to know, and of course, we are fascinated to see there. We are attracted towards the culture of those states. And if you go to a hillside, you will be astonished to see the difficult lifestyle of people, how they are climbing the mountains, fetching water. Okay, they have their limited needs, but the life in plain areas is much different. Okay, and in plain areas also, there is a lot of variety. Some have hot season, some have summer season, some have moderate type of climate. Okay, so this is where that there is a lot of variety in our country. Okay, which is again a source of attraction for tourists. So here we will read an interesting account about Goa. The third one point is, you may know that apart from the British, the Dutch and the French, the Portuguese have also played a part in the history of our country. So you know what French and Portuguese and Dutch people, they have played a part in our history. They have also come to India. Okay, tell me. अभी पता चला. Okay. Then that you can ask your social science teacher. Okay, even I will find it out that what great role these people have played. Okay. Can you say which parts of India grow tea and coffee? Where tea and coffee? Assam. This is much commonly asked question. But first of all, we are going to read from a baker from Goa. Many points to be remembered. So underlying side by side. Okay. The first is, this is a pen portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in his society. Who has written it? Traditional Goan baker. Okay, a baker from Goa. Pen portrait means, what is the meaning of pen portrait? Description in written. Okay, what is portrait actually? Describing the person. Pen portrait means written description about Goa. So, this is a pen portrait of traditional Goan baker who still has an important place in his society. So how he holds an important place in his society, this we are going to read. Our elders are often heard reminiscing. What is the meaning of reminiscing? Nostalgically. Reminiscing means, remnants means thinking about the past. Nostalgically means with great interest and feeling sorry for the past days, remembering those old great days. Reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days. Now, what he is saying, that our elders, they are always remembering those great days of Portuguese days when Portuguese people, they used to visit our Goa. The Portuguese and their famous loaves of bread. You know that what it is called as single piece of bread, it is loaf. Okay. How many loaves make a? एक ब्रेड में कितने लोग्स होते हैं? 21 और 23? इवन आई एम कंफ्यूज्ड. यू नो पर्टिकुलर नंबर इज देयर. सो द पोर्चुगीज एंड देयर फेमस लोव्स ऑफ ब्रेड. यस, दीज पोर्चुगीज पीपल, दे आर फेमस फॉर देयर लोव्स ऑफ ब्रेड बिकॉज दे वर बेकर्स. Those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. Those eaters. It means that the writer is displaying the mortality of human beings. That those people who were eating those loaves of bread, they might have dead. They might have been dead. But those people who have prepared their loaves, they are still present. Okay. At least at one point it is contradictory. Agar wo mar sakte to wo kyun nahi? The thing is that. That business has been passed on to the further generations. This is the reason. Huh? This is what I'm saying. Contradictory it is there, na? Okay, the thing is that he wants means to deliver is that those people who are making those loaves of bread, they have passed on to the generation. Okay? This skill. Okay? Khane walon ne apna khane ka skill thoda na pass karna hai. Thing is this. Right? So, we still have amongst us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. So, these are the different categories of the people who are involved in the process of baking. So, what he is saying, we among all, now we have mixers, those who mix the dough, okay, the flour, and the molders who mold them into desired shapes. You will come to know. The bengal shaped breads, bengals are also there, these molders, and as well as those ones who bake these loaves. The fire in the furnace, what is furnace? It's a place, okay, in which by kindling the fire, high temperature is maintained to bake the bread, to turn it raw into eatable form. The fire in the furnace has not yet been extinguished. The thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo, heralding means announcing his arrival in the morning. Thud and jingle means, thud means the sound produced when one stab or one puts the stick onto the ground. That is thud sound, jingling. Some you can say, jaise ghungru type nahi hote like that. Something is attached to it which is producing a jingling sound. Okay, so when this thud and jingling sound is produced by the baker, it announces the oncoming of the baker to the living locality. can still be heard in some places. And this kind of sound, it can also be heard at some places. So what is, how or what announces the arrival of the arrival of this? You can say the baker, thud and jingling sound of the stick. It announces the oncoming of the baker. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. These bakers are even today known as Pader in Goa. So maybe the fathers, they have been dead, but they have passed on to this business to their generations. And what is the traditional name given to a baker in Goa? It is Pader. Underline it in your books, please. Kindly bring your books tomorrow. Right? Bring this first flight. So, what are they called as? Commonly called as? They are commonly called as Pader. Okay, they are commonly called as Pader in Goa. During our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, a companion and guide. So, what kind of role was played by the baker when the writer was quite young? A friend, a companion and guide. Underline it, friend, because they share gossips, companion sometimes. They used to play and guide. Sometimes he used to tell them important things. He used to come at least twice a day. So for how many times? Underline it. I'm telling you to underline it for the sake of MCQs. So for how many times Pader is coming to their houses? Twice a day, two times a day. Once when he set out in the morning on his selling round, and then again when he returned after tying his huge basket. So these two times, what does this signify? That it is not two times he is coming for selling the bread. First time he is coming with his bra basket full of bread when he has come to sell it, and the second time he used to come in with an empty basket on his returning round. So, the jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. So, most of the times the children, they were sleeping, and early in the morning he used to come to sell his bread. And what the writer is saying, he's saying that when we hear this thud and jingling sound of the bamboo, we were quite excited to see him. We ran out of our beds in order to meet him, because that was actually a thing to relish. They enjoy. Have you ever eaten those freshly baked breads which are hot? They are really very tasty. So soft. Because when they are delivered to our houses, they have turned out to be, you can say, a little bit hard. But when it is baked, freshly baked, it's really very tasty. So, the jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it for the love of the loaf? Not at all. The loaves were bought by some peskin or bestine. Underline it. By some peskin or bestine, the maid servant of the house. The writer is saying that why we were running? In order to, when we listen to this sound, it is just because that we love those loaves? No, it is actually brought by peskine or bestine, the maid servants of the house. And what we longed for were those bread bangles which we chose carefully. But we long for means having strong desire of. Long for means having strong desire of, but he said that we have strong desire of having those loaves, okay, those loaves of bread which are actually in the shape of bangles, and we call it as bread bangles. Sometimes it was sweet bread or special make. Sometimes what kind of bread it is? Special type of bread which is sweet in taste, okay, which is sweet in taste. So now three main things we have learned here. Who is Pader? It is the traditional name of the Goan baker. Who is Pascine and Bestine? Maid servants who purchase the loaves of bread. Okay. And how many times the baker is coming to their houses? Twice a day. Which means? Twice a day means? In the morning, in the evening. How? Yes, at one time he is coming to sell his bread, and then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket. Okay, so here nowhere it is mentioned morning and evening. Morning is mentioned only, but evening is not mentioned. Okay, so don't make a mistake here. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the jang jang sound of his specially made bamboo staff. Staff means strong and sturdy stick. So how is the entry of the baker is made? Here it is the answer, that he made his musical entry. What kind of entry the baker is making? Musical entry the baker is making. How this musical sound is produced? By the jang jang sound. What is producing this jang jang sound? The bamboo staff. Staff means strong and sturdy stick, which he is thudding onto the ground in this manner while moving, and it is producing a jang jang sound. One hand supported the basket on his head and the other banged the bamboo onto the ground. So what is the posture? How he is coming? He is holding a basket over his head. One hand was supporting the basket, and with the other hand he is putting down the bamboo staff onto the ground to produce the sound. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. See, so when he enters the house, first of all he greets the lady of the house. Okay, he will take off his basket, or he will take the basket off his head, and it will ultimately, it will settle down on the bamboo stick. Maybe it is in the form of a stand, maybe it is in the form of a cross on which he is making his basket stay. You must have seen that some kind of those people, those vendors in the market. So they used to settle up their basket on a, you can say, sort of a stand. So he would greet the lady and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. We kids would be pushed aside with the mild rebuke, and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. So when the kids, they were hovering around, yes, I want this, I want this, little bit of rebuke was given, scolding was given, you will be go aside. These loaves of bread will be given by the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench or the parapet and peep into the basket. Somehow, I can still recall the typical fragrance of these loaves. So, but the, you know that the children, they are very eager to see, and that smell, it is also very tempting. So he said that I can still remember that smell of the loaves of the bread. So what he is saying, we try to peep into the basket. What is there? Okay. Thing is not that, it is curiosity, out of just curiosity. They know that there is bread, but they wanted to see themselves. Sometimes they, you can say, they climb the parapet. Okay. You can say short rope without any support. Okay. Parapet also, in order to see what is there in the basket. Somehow I can still recall the typical fragrance of these loaves. Parapet, it is like sort of a shed. I can still recall the typical fragrance of these loaves. Loaves for the elders and bangles for the children. So there is a demarcation in the making of the loaves of bread. There are loaves of bread for the elders, and for the children, they are in the form of bangles. Bangles, they can play with these bangles and then they eat. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And why should we? We would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush. Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? See, here another example is given that they were not brushing up their teeth because they were not using toothpaste. Okay. What they were using? Mango leaf. Okay. He said, without brushing our teeth and without washing our face, we would pick up the mango leaf and would clean and would not brush, who will take the trouble, because that is really a difficult task for us, and who would take the trouble of plucking, and why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. So this is a comparison made, like kehte na sheron ka muh kabhi dhoye nahi hote. Okay, so this is, he said the tigers, they don't even brush their teeth. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. And when we take hot tea, it ultimately cleans our mouth. So that's all for Baker from Goa till here. Tomorrow we will continue further. And if you have any problem now, you can ask me.